Thank you, and thank you, Tecnaglia, for inviting me to this meeting. It is an interesting occasion for my institute, the Experimental Station for the Food Preserving Industry. It is a public institute for applied research regarding the production chain in the agri-food sector and food processing industry. SICA.
Excuse me, because there are a problem with the connection.
I see. Okay. Sorry. SICA is located in Parma and in Hungary, in the south of Italy. As said Marie Carmen, I'm responsible of a packaging department where we studied packaging material in metallic material, plastic, bioplastic, and closures in general for food product. We are collaborating with Tecnaglia, located in San Sebastian, on the European project BioCopac for the valorization of tomato wastes for the production of lacquer for metal packaging. And we are partner with Tecnaglia in the European project Legoval. Many foods are rich in protein. Protein are of animal origin, meat and fish, and of vegetable origins, cereal, legumes. Proteins are essential in food, not only for their nutritional value, but also as modulator of structure and perception of a food product. The functional behavior of a protein depends on the kind of food, representing a fundamental component in the food development and production. With increasing world population and welfare, the pressure on protein availability for food purposes has risen. More and more proteins are made available and commercialized to develop novel products with higher nutritional value and to improve the functional properties of the food system. Many kinds of proteins are used as food ingredients. They derive from eggs, dairy products, cereals, vegetables, legumes, in particular plasma. We can distinguish between two main roles of protein as food ingredient: a nutritional role and a functional role. Concerning the first one, we can use protein, we can add protein to the food in order to increase the nutritive value and the content of protein. Or we can use protein of vegetable origin in order to substitute protein of animal origin for specific class or consumer. An example is reported in this slide. Finally, protein are used as a nutritional supplement for specific diet, for example, sports. The functional behavior of a protein play a role to improve the consistency or structure of the food, for example, for meat product, or to increase the retention of liquid. An example is cooked ham. Again, protein are used to stabilize emulsion or form, such as mayonnaise, margarine, ice cream, or to improve the sensorial characteristics of food, taste, flavor, and finally to improve the shelf life of foodstuff by enhancing antioxidant or antimicrobial activity, or by producing edible films. Following what I said, it is very important to increase protein availability a number of routes can be followed. The first one concerns the optimization of cultivar for geographical location, in particular for cereals. The second route is the modulation of protein functional behavior by means of physical chemical method or via chemical engineering. Finally, we can obtain protein from alternative, less conventional sources. We can extract protein from algae, leaves, insects. We can use plants such as rice in order to produce human protein. And we can utilize food and food industrial wastes to extract, to produce proteins. The interest about the possibility of valorizing food wastes is increased recently. In fact, the problem of food waste is very large, spread all over the world. Of course, successful utilization of the new proteinaceous materials requires breakthroughs in extractability and the preservation of specific properties of proteins, their digestibility, nutritive value, organoleptic properties, and hygienic properties, of course. Particular attention is focused on the food industry byproducts that can represent an important source of protein for their characteristics and availability. The most important class of industry involved are the vegetables industry, in particular legume industry, where more than 500,000 tons per year of byproducts is produced in Europe. We can consider also animal byproduct, fish meal and meat blood meal is produced in more than 2 million tons per year. But the most important sector is the dairy industry, where the whey protein that contains about 2% of protein is produced in more than 2 million tons per year of byproducts. So the possibility of valorize these byproducts represent has also an economic advantage. The valorization of byproducts is part of a circular economy system, a zero waste program for Europe, recently object of a communication from the Commission to the European Parliament. The goal of this communication, very complex, is to keep the added value in products as long as possible and to eliminate waste. Considering protein byproducts, a new interesting application is the production of biopolymers and edible coatings for food packaging. In fact, protein present good barrier properties to water and oxygen, and in this way they can increase the shelf life of food packed in protein packaging. Protein can be used to produce biofilm, such as, or coupled with other plastic or bioplastic materials in order to obtain a multilayer, as you can see in this slide, with specific characteristics. But the protein's byproduct can be used to produce edible coating, to be applied on paper, on plastic materials, or directly on food in pieces. An example is the fruit in yogurt, for example. protein packaging are not or yet available on the market, but there are a lot of research, experimental works, paper, patents on this subject because it's a very interesting and new application. In this slide I listed some examples from the literature. It's possible to use jumbo squid and KPEG by protein to produce biofilm. Another example refer to the use of soy protein added with cysteine for packing fresh cut Thelma eggplants. Or we can combine ketosan and cyclodextrine in order to obtain a packaging appropriate for chicken fillets. Other example concern the utilization of citrus pectin and the protein fasolin and the whey proteins. The protein package can be used not only for food but also for cosmetic, in the field of cosmetic and pharmaceutical, because the protein, for example, zein, can be used as a drug carrier system to deliver the therapeutic in more precise and controlled manner in vivo. SICA and Tecnalia are partners in the project, European project Leguval, on the valorization of legume co-products and byproducts for packaging application. The goal of the project is the utilization of proteins and fiber for the improvement of bioplastic barrier properties. This project is based on a SICA patent. The byproducts, the legume byproducts, peas, beans, or lentils, are produced during the process, industrial process of transformation of the legumes. Now the byproducts discarded are destined to animal feed and compost, and they represent an additional cost for the industry. So the possibility of valorizing these byproducts is an advantage, an economic and advantage for the food industry. SICA has set up a method of extraction of protein on a pilot scale. As you can see in this slide, the peas or beans byproducts are grinding and homogenized and solubilized in a solution in order to extract protein. Then the protein are precipitated by acidification and separated by centrifugation. At the end, we obtain a powder of protein extract using a spray dry technique.
Excuse me, Angela, you have 5 minutes.
Okay, just. The powder can be added with water and a plastificant glycerol in order to obtain a film. As you can see in this figure, the film is transparent. Without macroscopic defects, it has a good barrier properties to oxygen, good mechanical properties, it is edible, biodegradable, and suitable for compost production. I speed up the presentation. Here you can see an application of this film on hamburger. In this case, the film substitutes the cellophane. And the advantage is that this film, this protein-based film, can be cooked and eaten with the film, with the product, without modification of the taste. Another possible application is to some vegetable, fresh vegetables, to control the shelf life, to prolong the shelf life. In this case, the film is applied as an edible coating by immersion of the mushroom, in this case, directly in the solution forming film. As you can see, after 6 days of storage, the surface of the mushroom is good, is acceptable, the consistency is good, and no mold were observed on the surface. But I think that a very interesting application is on the truffles, because truffles are very expensive products, and in Italy it is important to it is an important market for the exportation to United States. So it is very important to limit, to prolong the shelf life, and in particular to limit the loss of weight of this product because of its cost. We study a new application of protein-based film in a combination of a chitosan film with an antimicrobial activity. In this way, as you can see in this figure, in this picture, after 14 days of storage, the consistency, the appearance of the truffles were good, no fungal and other microorganisms were developed on the surface, and very important, no modification of flavor and taste. So this is an interesting application, and that imply a very economic advantages. In conclusion, I can see that the valorization of protein byproduct is an opportunity for the packaging field and for reducing food industrial wastes. Thank you for